Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I'm continuing on with my OneNote app for desktop series, and I'm going to be specifically looking at different features, essential features to help you get more out of your OneNote experience. I'm going to go ahead and open up my OneNote app, and I just want to point out the version that I'm using here. So as I open it up, this one right here, OneNote app, is the one I'm going to be talking about the features on today. OneNote for Windows 10, I have different videos on using that one. Over the course of the next year, you are going to see Microsoft merge their OneNote versions into one, so that'll be a lot less confusing. If you're looking to learn more about this OneNote app, I have a beginner's tutorial that I'll put a link down below in the description and up above in the card. But I'm going to go ahead and open up this one here, and then we can start talking about some of these great features that it has in it. Everything in this video will be timestamped, so if you want to look down below in the description, you can look at the list of features and then just click on the time and jump to that part of the video. So let's get started with the first feature, and that is using tags. And this is a super powerful part of using Microsoft OneNote and keeping organized. So in this case here, I just made a example OneNote, some sections and pages about maybe planning a trip. And I'm gonna add some tags to these. So let's say this right here, this is something that's going to be important. It's a link to a tour that I want to do. The tags, if you notice, right up top here, I have different tabs. I have a to-do tag here. But if I drop down right here, I have a list of different ones that I can add. So if I go ahead and add important to this, I have the star like this. So maybe here's a one with a video on it. I can tag this one differently. Maybe I want to say this is a movie to see, and I'll just remind myself that I'm placing videos in like this. I could go to different places. You can see there's some tags on this one here. We could go, maybe there's a book you want to read. This one looks like it's on the wrong page, but if there's a book, there's even a tag for that, so you can add a book tag. So the tags are nice and everything, but where it becomes powerful is when you go to find your tags. So what I mean by that is if you go ahead and click find tags now, it gives you this list here of all the different places you have tags. You can see that there's from a book to read, there's ideas, there's important ones, movie to see. So if I go ahead and click to this one, the idea one, it brings me to that page. So just imagine as you're using OneNote more and more, and you get maybe tens of pages or hundreds of pages, using that tagging can save you a lot of time. If you look at the list too, if you go down to the very bottom, you can see you can do customized tags in this case. So if you want to customize your own, and you can remove the tags also right from this point too. So taking advantage of the tags is, I think, an essential part of OneNote, and probably one of the things to get yourself using quite a bit. So this next feature is very easy and quick to show. Here's my example. This is just an image right here. So I took this from the internet, just a brochure. It has text in it, as you can see. I can quickly pull the text out and paste it. Watch this. If I go ahead and right click, I have copy text from picture. So I'm just going to choose that. And I could go to a different page if I wanted to, but right on this page, at this spot here, I'm just gonna go paste, Control V, and look at that. I pulled the text from this picture right here. So that's just a super quick feature that I wanted to show you, that Microsoft OneNote, how that works. A very important feature of Microsoft OneNote is the ability to share. So you can collaborate with a person or a group of people, but you need to be thinking about how you're sharing. And I just want to talk about this feature here. Now, if I take a look at this planning a trip one that I have, this notebook trip planning, this one actually is saved locally on my computer. That poses a problem to share out with people if I wanted to be working in live time. So let me explain this. So if I go to a different notebook like this Jamie at Work one, this has nothing in it here. But if I go to file here, here's my different notebook information. This one is actually saved on my OneDrive. So when I created it, it saved on my OneDrive, so it allows me to share quickly. So what I mean by this is, if I go to invite people to this notebook now, I already have some people invited. I could add some more people if I wanted to, or I could remove them. So if I right click, remove, that person's gone. Just Kathy has edit with also me that on this notebook here. If I wanted to add a person back, I can just type in their name up top and give them can view or can edit. I'll give this person can view and then just hit share. And then I have three people that we could be collaborating with this notebook based on the permissions that they have. So that makes it really easy to do that. If I go back here to info, just pointing out this one's saved in the cloud, and I'm gonna go back one more level. I could also right click on a section. Take a look at this, copy link to the section. If I copy the link to the section and I went to, let's say, an email, and I'm just gonna paste it in, if I hover over it, you can see that this would give me a link to that person. They would need to be part of the sharing settings on it, but maybe I had some meeting notes and I could just be, here's the link to today's meeting notes, and they click on it and open up in OneNote. Now, also, I can right click on a page, so copy link to a page. So you have some different options when it's being shared in the cloud. Now, what I would have to do though, with these other ones here, like trip planning, if I wanted to share this with other people, I would need to move it. So if you notice, if I share on, I'm gonna hit share. To share this notebook, you'll need to put it in OneDrive or SharePoint. I just wanna point out here that this one is saved locally. If I hit browse here, and this one is on my computer, you can see here. Now, where I would need to move this one is to my OneDrive here. If I hit browse, if I take a look at this, you can see here's my one notebook that I have that was shared. I would need to move that trip planning one over to my OneDrive to be able to share like the ways that I showed you. But one thing you could do here, and this is something different, and I'm gonna go to, if I go and look at these different ones like trip planning here, if I go to export, what I could do is select a page or section or a notebook and export it. So I could export a page and save it as, you can see, a .one file here, or a section, or even I could package the whole notebook. And at that point, if I did that, I could send it to someone as a file, or maybe put it on a USB stick if you didn't want to use the cloud to do this. And then they could open it up and see all the information that they had, and they could do whatever they want with it, but you wouldn't be working in live collaborative time. So those are some sharing options that you have with using Microsoft OneNote. So if you want to make one of your sections a little bit more secure, you can add a password. So how to do this? If I went over one of these, and we'll just say, we'll stick with this US Trips one, I'm going to right click on this and take a look at password protect this section. So I'm going to choose this, and then we have password protection opens up here. Now what I do is I need to set a password. So I'm going to choose this. I'll pick something super easy. But remember, look at the caution underneath. If you lose or forget the password, OneNote cannot recover your data. So make sure you know your password. I'm going to hit OK. Now at this point, I'm just going to say keep existing backups here. And I can lock all now. So there's a shortcut, Control Alt and L. Or I can just click here, lock all. Now, if I go over to my other sections, you can see that I can get into those fine. But if I go back to this one, if I hit enter at this point, I'd have to enter my password in, and then it opens up. If you want to remove your password, go ahead and hit remove, and then just put your password in again, and then there is no password to this one anymore. So take a look at the password protection to add a little bit more security to each section. So what I'm going to do now is install an add-in for Microsoft OneNote, and I'm going to install the learning tool. So we'll give it just a few other options. So I'll put the link to this page down below in the description, but at this point I can just go ahead and download this, and it's a kind of a quick install on it. And if you don't like it, you can go to your settings and uninstall learning tools from there too. But I'm going to go ahead, get this installed, and I'm going to open up my OneNote again, and you're going to have a brand new tab on it. So if I look across my tabs now, I have learning tools. So I have a brand new tab, and inside you can see the ribbon right here, immersive, reader, and dictate. Now I do want to point out that if I go to view here, immersive readers right here, I've also had problems with mine connecting. So if I go ahead and select it, it just spins around and around. I'm going to exit out of this one, but now I'm going to go over to this section. I have some text here. If I go to my learning tools and select Immersive Reader, it picks up the text. So what it does is it can read back the text.
Tools that read text out loud.
So it can go through and read text, and then I can customize it to even more by selecting things from text size to spacing to font to themes, whatever helps the person consume their information in a more accurate way. We can also go through and even break down things like verbs and nouns in it. And if the person's speaking too slow or too fast, we can adjust it through the voice speed or even pick a different person to hear a different voice on it. Now that's Immersive Reader. I do want to point out too, take a look at this. If I go to US trips, remember that picture that I pulled the text out of? If I have this selected and I go to my Immersive Reader, it can pull the information out of there. So if I scroll down, it can read that text out of a picture. So this is all the text that was in there. So even from a picture, if I use Immersive Reader, it can do that. The other thing that got added was Dictate. So I'm gonna go to this last section again. So what Dictate allows me to do quickly, and just as a quick example, so Dictate allows me to dictate any notes that I want, and you can see it get added quickly to the page that I'm on. So just like that. So I turned it off, but now I have this dictation right through here that I've added. So by adding the learning tools add-in, I have these two things that are working for me now. And you can, if you take a look, I'm just gonna right click and customize the ribbon. And I showed you this in my beginner's tutorial. If we take a look at the add-ins, now we have the add-in right through here, the learning tools that was installed. And remember what I said, you can go to your settings and uninstall learning tools on your computer, and it will remove it from OneNote. If you're not interested in dictating notes to turn it into text, you can record your voice too. If we look under Insert and then take a look at the record audio here, when you select this, right away it's going to start recording. You can see the number going up here on mine. When I want to have it stopped, I could hit stop, and now I have a recording of my voice that I could go back in, and then I can go see playback. I do have audio settings here if you needed to choose where it was going to be recorded from, but you can go back and test out your audio after you record it just for those quick notes. Another powerful feature is the translate feature. Take a look at the review tab up top and then translate right here. So I'm going to go ahead and just highlight this text right here about Vancouver I have and select translate. So when I select this, it's based on the selected text. So I could select it. You can see it opens up right here. It's just English from English. I could drop down. I could pick a different language. So if I wanted it to turn it to French or German, it quickly does this. And as soon as I hit insert, it changes this over. So if you speak German, you can tell me how accurate the translation was on this. But you can go ahead and choose other languages very quickly to adapt to any of these. So take a look at this. Let me know in the comments down below if it is accurately translating the languages over. I find it works very quickly, and you have lots of different options to choose from with your translations. So the last thing that I just want to show you for a feature today, just kind of a fun feature in this, I'm just going to go to this section here. I'll close down this, is just that we can take things that we write. So ink to text. If we go to our draw right here, it's ink to text is right here. It's not showing up right now because I don't have it selected. So what I can do is to make my selection around, make sure everything's included in it. And as soon as it's selected, you can see that there's ink to text. So if I select it, it turns text or turns what I've written and turns it into a typed, so it makes my handwriting or hand printing looks a lot better like that. So I hope you liked all these different features in using OneNote. There's still more to learn about OneNote and all the different things it could do. I just thought this would be a nice step after my beginner's OneNote tutorial that I mentioned before, and I'll put the link to it. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.